Gary, that's get a few points back on the board after.
Well, that was the aim before the game. You know, we've done that. Although we made it hard for ourselves again. But, you know, probably on the balance of play, we felt we deserved it. And, you know, we probably should have made it 2-0 on the last stage of the game, with Rennes going through. But no, I'm happy with the 1-0 victory and the effort of the players in the second half after going down to 10 men, was one hand shot incredible.
Well, yeah, because I was speaking to Jamie Todd earlier, and I'm just saying to him that maybe Queen's kind of played into his and Big Craig's hands because he started to loft the ball in.
Well, what we did, Jim, is we made sure that they weren't going to be able to, you know, play through us, and we actually made them play along, which did suit us with Craig and Toddy and Jamie Piper and Harvey Swan going and heading things. I mean, when things were dropping, young Chris Hamilton and Robbie Buchanan for that period were getting on the end of second balls and getting us back up the pitch again. You know, and I even felt that we had even when we were doing the 10-man, we had the better chances in the game as well.
Aye, yeah, well, there was a couple of really good ones. Yeah. Young Connor got into a good position and just got
I think he wasn't aware of the lad coming and, you know, closing him down behind him. Maybe a better touch, but, you know, it was another good position we were in. But I thought the two, you know, the team where I was standing today, the 10, but I thought the two young kids for Hearts today showed, you know, tremendous maturity in their play. We moved young Hammy forward one position today, played him in all the park, and I felt he was excellent. I thought he was an outstanding, probably the best player on the pitch today.
I was going to say that Kyle's suspension left you a couple of spaces to fill, really, because you chose to just move things around a wee bit, as you say, with Robbie moving forward as well and Chris. But the first half, they were just...
Well, we're at home and we need to go and win games, Jim. You know, we're on a run that wasn't as good as we were hoping. So we went with a team that were, you know, more forward-thinking today and getting us forward. You know, and a bit of pace with the team. And you know, a little bit of a more of a goal threat. We have been creating chances. No scoring, may I add. But also, we've not been making goalkeepers, you know, save the ball. And I felt with these players in the forward area that we would cause Queen's Park a bit of problems, and that was probably to be the point.
And I was going to say that no game next week, but maybe with sort of the injury situation, it's maybe with Jordan Allen being out and what have you, it's maybe no bad thing.
No, it's not a bad thing, but you know, we're supposed to be, or we should be. I've not been knocked out of the cup, should have been playing next Saturday, so I'll not be a weekend off for the guys, that's for sure. So we've still got a lot of work to do. We'll train next week, Tuesday, Thursday, and how we go, whether we get a bounce game at the weekend or we get a training session, the guys will certainly be working over the weekend as well.
Because I'll be in Rovers the next game in a fortnight. That result, I was looking at the league table, just four behind the second top, so... You know, I'm trying to get a wee run going again.
Well, you're always wanting to win games, Jim, but, you know, there's someone put in front of you that tries to stop you winning games, called the opposition.
Mm-hmm.
They're all difficult games. So, no, we go to Albion Rovers, difficult place to go, as we know. You know, we've found out things difficult against them in the past, I'm sure. We thought next time will be no different. But we go there, on the back end of a win, and try to keep this, you know, get ourselves on another winning run as well.
Perfect. Thanks very much.
Cheers, guys. Thank you.